Hi everyone, this is a video on conduction of power system simulation lab 6th experiment. The 6th experiment is formation of Y bus by singular transformation with mutual coupling. See, in the earlier two experiments we have seen the formation of Y bus with inspection method and using singular transformation, but in this video you will be understanding the execution of the program with mutual coupling. You see the topic formation of Y bus using inspection method, okay, with mutual coupling. For a given power system, we will write the code like how I am written in the MATLAB. Okay, first for a given system, okay, first what is the system given? Okay, for which we have to write the Y bus using singular transformation. Here, unlike in the previous, okay, there we didn't have that mutual coupling. In this problem, we have a mutual coupling. I discussed this same problem in the PSA2 theory class. Here also I am discussing the same theory, and theory whatever you do for the finding of Y bus using singular transformation, the same technique is taken in the program, okay, and thereafter how this program can be implemented in MATLAB environment and how to get the result I will explain now. So here, as we know, here we have 4 buses, 1, 2, 3, 4 buses, and how many lines? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. Here it is given, lines are 5, element numbers are 5, and here self means self impedance is given for 5 lines, 1, 2, all 5 lines are there, no? 5 lines are connected between 1, 2, 1, 3, 3, 4, 1, 2, 2, 4, bus numbers are given 1, 2, 3, 4, so you are just marking the line impedances here, 0.6, 0.5, 0.5, 0.4, 0.2, and here we have a mutual coupling. So between 1,3 and 1,2 of 1, 1,3 means what? 1,3 means here, yeah, this line, and 1,2 of 1 is this line. These two lines are in mutual coupling. How much is that value? 0.1. And similarly, 1,2 of 2 and 1,2 of 1, that means 1,2 of 2 and 1,2 of 1, between these two we have mutual coupling, 0.2. So these are the data it is given, and I will be taking this data into the program, okay. So that means enter the number of buses it will ask. Enter the number of buses means 4 you will type, okay, 4 buses. Enter the number of lines, 5 lines, 5 lines you will type. Enter the mutual impedance values. Mutual impedance values are here, 0, 0.1, 0, 0.2, 0. In the matrix form you have to type. Enter the line impedances. See, line impedances. Each line self impedance value is given, 0.6, 0.5, 0.5, 0.4, 0.2. Line impedances in a matrix form as you should type. And it will ask, enter the lines from bus and to bus. See here, from bus and to bus. How the transmission lines are connected. Okay. See here, in the, this is actually 1, 2, 1, 3, 3, 4, 1, 2, 2, 4. That means it is 5 cross 2 matrix that you have to type. So I will show you in the program how this has been implemented. Okay. Students, you see here how the input data is taken. Number of buses, 4. Number of lines, 5. And here, enter the mutual impedance values, the last column in that given data. The data we will be giving in the exam, and you have to type the last column values here. And before that, after that you have to write the line impedances. I explained, no? So line impedances given in the table. And from bus and to bus also it is given. That column you have to write in the matrix format. Okay. Once you complete all these input data, we are giving that here. See, N number of buses, NL number of lines, mutual impedance, line and then line. So all these are the inputs. So how to take the inputs from the given system I explained. and what the values we give for each variable. So n, nl, z mu, these are user defined variables. These are user defined variables. So first we have to take the data, then we have to form the A matrix. A matrix you have to form here. So how you can form? First you have to initialize that order, that is A is nothing but bus incidence matrix. The order of this matrix is elements cross buses. Elements are here, as you know, there are yes, it is clearly you can see here, elements are 5, okay, buses are 3, 4 actually. First bus you have to take it as reference bus, leaving the reference bus, the remaining buses, okay, you have to take, that is 5 cross 3. So that is what it is taken here, 5 cross 3, and then here a element is connected between only 2 buses. So you consider each element number of lines, so each line is connected between 2 nodes. So it is connected between 2 nodes means 1 minus 1, that means L matrix, we know L matrix, in that you have to call P value, and then if J is equal to 1, you just put the values of I and J, and L matrix you get, from that P you will get. So you just calculate the matrix how we obtain theoretically in the same way the program has been written to obtain the same. And here we have to find the element node incidence matrix, that what I explained, all the buses you will consider, but first bus you have to omit, no? That's why in the, so before comma here, comma, before comma, colon if you write, all rows we will consider, and if you write 1 means first column, after comma, column, so you are making null, that means you are eliminating the column corresponding to the reference bus. Then you have to find the Y. So formula remains same, Y bus is equal to A transpose Y into A, but Y it is not given, because here you see all impedances are given. First primitive impedance matrix you have to find, then primitive admittance matrix, reciprocal you have to take. So that's why first primitive impedance matrix here you have to find. Here see, here this is primitive impedance matrix, that is 5 cross 5, elements are how many? 5, therefore it is 5 cross 5. And this matrix is nothing but A1, that means you see the given data, yeah, given data here, see 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, that means the particular element is mutually coupled, then it is 1, if it is not coupled, 0. So one element, 1 is not coupled, therefore it is 0, value is there means it is coupled. So 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, that is what it is written here, 0 1 0 1 0. So first we have to consider the self impedances of all the 5 lines, okay, self impedance of all the 5 lines, Z line. So diagonal, it is 5 cross 5, but it is mutual coupling, no? You have off diagonal elements also. To find out that off diagonal element, this logic we will use. A1 of I is greater than 0, then primitive of that 1, 2, 1, 4 are the 2 mutual coupled, that you have to consider here. And once you find the Z primitive, means Y primitive you can find here, inverse of Z primitive. Once you know that Z primitive, you can find Y primitive here. Y bus is equal to A transpose Y into Y primitive. These two, if you want, you can see the value of A transpose and Y bus. So this is how we do. And then see here, A matrix you can find, okay, A matrix, automatically it will calculate in the program, final answer is this. See the program how we do in the MATLAB. So MATLAB, you type the program as it is, you type the program, okay. What you do after the first, I'll clear the command window, okay. Now you run the software, enter the number of buses. Enter the number of buses. There are 4 buses, type 4. Enter the number of lines, you type 5. And then enter the mutual impedance values. Mutual impedance values you enter, that is this value. Okay, already I typed, that's why it is coming. Then enter the line impedance values, that is this value. Already it has been done for practice. Then enter the lines from bus to bus. Yes, you can consider this. So once you enter the given data, automatically the Y bus will calculate. Okay, this is how one can find the Y bus using singular transformation with mutual coupling. Okay, so with this I will end the video. Thank you.